All right, so it looks like I have some Korean fried chicken. Got these big old drumsticks. And these nice little wings here. Display them for you guys. So I got this at Bonchon here. Oh my God, it took me forever. Damn, that tastes good. All right. Oh my God, I am so hungry. You don't even understand. Gotta mix this up. Got a big old mean plate of black bean noodle. Gotta mix that all up in there. Yes. Scrape all of this sauce out there. I'm so hungry right now. I think I'm gonna freaking kick someone's ass. I'm hungry because your ass took so long to decide on a restaurant. 40 minutes later, I'm starving like a damn child. Always happens. This always happens. My mouth is probably a mess. Okay, you redeemed yourself. You chose the right restaurant, the right food. This is freaking amazing. Oh my God. This one has a kick. This is real good. This is pickled radish. All right. This is so good. I'm not mad at you anymore. But I really was pissed off though. Like, I came home from such a long day. Both my dogs came up to me. My boyfriend greeted me. But as I was carrying in the food, I was like, don't fucking touch me. I have to film. And here I am, eating like a beast. I don't even care if my mouth is messy. Very good, very. So, I got this black bean noodle at this restaurant called Peking Gourmet. It's located in Garden Grove. And it's in Koreatown, Garden Grove. I asked my friends, my Korean friends, to see which black bean noodle they like best from which restaurant, and they decided on Peking Gourmet, which is amazing. Because Diane, the owner of Peking Gourmet, is incredible. She's so freaking sweet. Ah, I love her. She was so cute because I called in the order. She had everything ready. I walked in. She was so kind. And I told her what I was doing with her food, and that some of my friends said that her black bean noodle was the best. And She got so excited about it. She was so cute about it. And I told her what I was gonna do with the food. You know, I feel myself eating it. I had to explain it to her. And when she found out what I was doing, she was so kind. Like, she went out of her way to explain to me how to prepare it. She was so concerned. She asked me, "When are you gonna eat this?" I said, "Oh, probably within 2 hours." And she told me, "Okay, just make sure that you run warm water through the noodles because it's gonna stick. It's gonna stick. And you have to make sure that you microwave the sauce up." She was so cute and motherly about it. I'll put the information of the restaurant below. That is so good. And if you happen to visit the restaurant, please make sure to ask for Diane. And tell her Thien sent you, okay? Just make her happy, make her day. She was really excited about it, and I'm so happy to be able to have her noodles on YouTube. So, Diane, this one's for you. And I got these from Bonchon. I don't know if you know what Bonchon is. I think it's a chain, right? Of it's just, how do you say? It has Korean food, has Japanese food, but I think that their Korean fried chicken is what makes Bonchon, right? That is their premier menu item. Also, Korean fried chicken is a little different from, I would say, regular fried chicken. I think their technique is that they double fry it. So you get this kind of crispier outside. Excuse me. Perrier makes me burp. And then as far as the flavors go, I have spicy, right? Which is probably their most popular choice. And I have soy garlic for their wings. It's actually quite great. I love that double fried action. So good, this food. I'm so happy. I need to remember to wipe my face. Messy, but really damn good. So if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I just got back from Seattle. Seattle was amazing. Any trip really is amazing. Just getting out of town is incredible. So please, if you can, just run away. Use that money on vacation. It's so worthwhile because I really feel like memories made during vacation. There's like really, I guess there's really no price to it. That's why I'm so willing to throw that money at it. I really don't care for material things anymore. I just kind of need that vacation action. It's funny that we go on vacation, but the thing is that with vacation, you know, we're supposed to relax and feel at ease, but I feel like for the most part, when I'm on vacation, I don't feel relaxed. I feel like there's so much chaos, there's so much planning, and there's so much work to it that it almost doesn't seem like a vacation. So what this was that I went to Seattle just for my 30th birthday, which passed last year, my friends as well. But we didn't really get a chance to do something really huge, you know? So we got together, the nine of us, and we had a blast. We just went crazy. We drank a lot, if you saw my Snapchat. Let me just tell you, the people from Seattle are quite different from the people in California, or at least in Orange County or LA. Now, the one thing they do share is that, you know, well, California and Washington are liberal states. So, but as far as, like, I don't know, behavior, fashion sense, totally different, not the same. I mean, I honestly think we stuck out like sore thumbs. You know, when we go out, typical Orange County LA kids, we like to dress up. Like, we like to wear some intense things. Shorter skirts or whatever, just because the weather allows us to, you know? So we did that anyway when we went out. And I really think that those stares that we got were, I don't think they were bad stares. I just think that they knew we were from out of town, obviously, because it was really, really cold. It was about 40 degrees. And there were days where it was kind of drizzling, snowing. Yeah, it was cold. I mean, Seattleites dress for comfort, right? They have their big poofy jackets. They have their Patagonia fleece sweaters, jackets, whatever, whatever. They have all those. North Face. But as dumb California kids, even one of my friends showed up with freaking flip-flops on. Sandals. I looked at her and I was like, you're absolutely fucking insane. Like, it's so cold right now. She did it anyway, and that's why people were staring. And it was funny, because at first, we had to kind of get around with Uber and all that good stuff to our Airbnb. And the first few people we encountered were, I don't know if they were necessarily rude or mean. They just, I don't know. I just didn't like the way they treated us. So it was kind of off-putting. And there was, mind you, this was just when I stepped, I mean, basically stepped out of the airport and got into a car, the first Uber driver just really did not care for us and all our luggage pieces, like, did not care to help us. But he did anyway because he felt obligated or whatever the case was. So that was cool. I just passed that off as, all right, probably just him. It was cold out, it was wet, whatever. And then we got to our Airbnb, and we were exploring all that good stuff. I went outside on the balcony, and I saw the neighbor that was staying next door to our left, and I said hello, right? It's a nice hello. She straight up looked at me, looked up from whatever she was doing, and did not say a word. Just looked back down. Didn't even bother. And I thought to myself, all right, there's another person that could care less that we're here. I know neighbors hate Airbnb and all that good stuff, but my God, you could have just said hello back. And I thought, okay, that's it. I mean, I don't ever want to just say like a group of people are rude, because that's not true, you know? But it was a little off-putting, and I was getting worried. I was telling my friends, like, hey, is this a normal thing for Seattleites? I don't know if they... I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy, maybe I'm being ultra-sensitive, because I just am. And if people aren't nice to me, I get sad, like a sad Californian, you know? But I guess, yeah, I was kind of shocked. I don't know. So I said, okay, whatever, that was probably just, you know, her being annoyed that people were staying at the house next door and, you know, she's worried about the noise that we might be making tonight. I get it. So the second Uber driver picks us up, right, to go out of town, to go into the town and kind of hang out and see the restaurants and bars and all that good stuff. Oh my God. Did not care. He got pissed at us, actually, because his car did fit the amount of people that were waiting, but he did not want to take all of us. I was like, let's just drink. And if you guys saw my Snapchat of all those drinks, it was that night. I mean, me and my friends were so dumbfounded. Like, I really started almost blaming us for being so sensitive, because we're invading their territory, you know? We're these tourists that stick out like a sore thumb. But we didn't do anything wrong, you know? Which is surprising to me. So I kind of did a Google search, because I had to. I just had to figure out why we were being treated like this. And apparently it's a thing. I mean, if you Google... I think I Googled something along the lines of why are Seattleites rude or unhappy or unfriendly? Something along those lines. And there were actual, I would say, kind of links that showed up. Blogs or whatever. I was surprised to see it, because I didn't really want to believe it. But here's the thing, and after reading some, I do get it. I do understand why they are behaving that way. I mean, these people are educated people. They are... What it is that I think it's, for the most part, they're kind of, I would say, antisocial, or they don't really like to involve themselves in small talk or anything like that, you know, especially from a stranger. So I get it, I guess. I mean it's different everywhere, and I should not bring my set of beliefs and my own Orange County culture over there and expect too much. But I guess I was kind of, I don't know, I just had to know, right? So these educated people, they just feel like they don't really care to engage, and that's okay too, and that should be I guess acceptable from me, right? I mean, they weren't calling us names. They weren't being mean. They were just behaving in a way that we weren't used to, right? You know what I mean? But we did eventually run into wonderful people. Amazing, amazing people. So it has nothing to do with the group of people that live there. I think that, I guess it is a little different in Seattle than it is in, you know, LA, Orange County. A lot different, actually, but I enjoyed it for the most part. It was so fun. It was cold as hell, but it was fun. And honestly, to add to that, I guess what it is for us is that when anybody visits from out of state or out of the country and they're visiting California, I don't know if any other Californian can attest to this, but I do think that Californians are very, I don't know, we get oftentimes we get really excited about visitors, and I don't know what it is actually, and this is from my experience in customer service, you know. I just think for the most part, I've had this conversation before, that Californians are generally very curious about where you're coming from and why you're here. And we want you to basically enjoy the things that we enjoy. I would say that we're a happy group of people, and we maybe our happiness kind of just wants to explode all over you. You know, we want you to bask in that happiness. I don't know what it is. I just find that we're oftentimes very curious, and we're always like, oh, where are you coming from? Oh, that's so cool. And maybe that's why visitors always think Californians are super fake people. We may be, I don't know. But for me, when I'm asking questions like that, it's very genuine, actually. And I really do want to know where you're coming from and why you're here. And I do want to show you the places that are exciting. I was born and raised here. That's all I know. I just think that's, I don't know. We're just excited about stupid shit like that. And if we're called fake for it, then I guess I'll be a fake Californian. I'm happier anyway, so it doesn't matter, right? I don't know. Tell me about your experiences visiting California. I'm sure not every experience is perfect. I know you're going to run into some mean people everywhere, anywhere. These two go well with each other. No more noodles. You make me kind of nervous when you stare. Oh my gosh, I'm so burpy. Oh my gosh, I could eat these as snacks. Anyways, I'm just finally basically glad to be home again. The weather here is perfect. Everything's fine. I can't wait to go on my next trip. Seattle was a blast. And yeah, thank you for all those that gave me some suggestions, places to see and restaurants to eat at. Always appreciated. And I will still be looking for that job. Some of you guys are so kind. I got your messages, I got your note, I got everything from you, and I appreciate all the love. But don't be worried about me. I'll be fine. I'll figure it out. Next thing you know, I'll be an Uber driver. And if I pick you up, don't be surprised. But I'm gonna have another alias, I think. I really would be an Uber driver, but I would change my name. Never again am I drinking this. Making me burp so much. All right, beautiful people. I love you. You know that. Sorry about the hat. I got lazy. I flew in yesterday. I'm tired. Bye.